Testing. Good afternoon, St. John family and friends. We will be beginning our service in about 5 minutes. We ask that you view our presentation that we have on the monitors highlighting the significance of Black History Month, along with some contributions from inventors that you may or may not be aware of. Thank you.
He was down there shooting pictures a few minutes ago. Yeah. He was down there with Shirley and I was shooting pictures.
Okay.
Come on.
Jesus right there.
Let me get you so I can cop you in that picture. I'm gonna get you so I can cop you in that picture.
Oh.
Just take your mask off.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I'll cop you in it.
Okay.
Good afternoon once again to our St. John family, invited guests,
over here,
members, and friends. Black history is a heritage of unshakable faith. Faith enables us to draw strength and inspiration. It takes me to a familiar passage of scripture known as Isaiah 40, verse 31. It reads, "But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be faint." Opal Lee once said, "The fact is none of us are free till we are free." This brings me to a very familiar individual known as the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King. He gave a familiar speech. His speeches are known to give us a great sense of his powerful intellect, his profound spirituality, and enduring political philosophy. He continued to lay out his vision for a society free from racial injustice. At this time, we will have a rendition of the I Have a Dream speech by our very own pastor, the Reverend Dr. Jackson.
It's been a few years ago when I was a young lad. Matter of fact, back in 1963, I was watching my TV, black and white TV, rabbit ears, even with the little luminal foil extended to the rabbit ear.
Right.
And I was 12 years old, because this was in August, and my birthday was in October. I was about to be 13, but I was 12 at the time. And when he stepped up to the podium, he said, over 5 school years ago, a great American in whom we stand with signed the Emancipation Proclamation. Now, this came as a beacon light or a sign of hope for thousands of Negro slaves who had been sheared in the flames of injustice. It came as a joyous daybreak of a long night of captivity. But you know, 100 years later, the Negro is still not free. 100 years later, the Negro is still malice with discrimination. 100 years later, the Negro is still malice with segregation. 100 years later, the Negro finds himself exiled in his own land. There'll be no rest. There'll be no tranquility in America until the Negro receives his citizenship. The whirlwinds of revolt will continue to shake the foundation of this nation's capital until justice emerges. I say to you, my friends, no matter how difficult the moment may be, no matter how frustrating the hour may be within your life, I want you to know that I still have a dream. I have a dream that's deeply rooted within the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We believe that all men are created equal. I have a dream today. I have a dream that on the red hills of Georgia, the former slave owners and the slave owners would get together, sit down together at the table of brotherly love. I have a dream today. I have a dream that in the state of Alabama, little black boys, little white boys, little black girls, little white girls would join hands as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today. I have a dream that in the state of Mississippi, a state that is swarming with oppression and injustice, I have a dream that one day this state will rise up and be an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream today. I have a dream that my four little children won't grow up in a nation where they're judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. I have a dream that men would no longer burn down houses and the church of God just because the Negro wants to be free. I have a dream today. I have a dream that every hill and mountainside be made low, crooked places made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. I have a dream today. I have a dream that the words of Amos will become real. Just as a roll down like water, and righteousness like a mighty stream. I have a dream today. I have a dream that with this faith, I'll go back to the South. Go back to the South, not in despair, but go back to the South and hew out of the mountains of despair a stone of hope. With this faith, we'll be
together. With this faith, we are being able to worship together. With this faith, we will be able to go to jail together, knowing that one day we shall be free. With this faith, we will be able to sing together with a brand new meaning, "My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing, land where my fathers died, land of their pilgrim pride, from every mountainside, let freedom ring." Let freedom reign from the prestigious mountains of New Hampshire. Let freedom reign. Let freedom reign from the mighty mountains of New York. Let freedom reign. Let freedom reign from the heights and the Alleghenies of Pennsylvania. Let freedom reign. Let freedom reign from the red hills of Georgia. Let freedom reign. Not only that, not only that, let freedom reign from Lookout Mountains of Tennessee. Let freedom reign. Let freedom reign from the snow-topped mountains of Colorado. Let freedom reign. Let freedom reign from the curvaceous slopes of California. Let freedom reign. Not only that, not only that, let freedom reign from Stone Mountains of Georgia. Let freedom reign. Let freedom reign into the state of Mississippi, from every molehill and hill of Mississippi. Let freedom reign. And when we let freedom reign, we'll be able to speed up that great day. When all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, can join hands and sing in the old Negro spiritual, "Free at last, free at last, thank God Almighty, we are free." Woo, at last.
Thank you, Dr. Jackson, so much for speaking to us about a dream that one day we'll all be free. At this time, we will begin the final part of our program, which is a fellowship. We will be releasing everyone to have their dinner by tables. I will be calling each table based on the person that is listed in front of you, pictured in front of you. You will enter in the community room to this door to my right. We ask that each one get hand sanitizer first, and it is on the table. So we will begin with this first table to my right, which is Joe Lewis at this time. We ask that you please continue viewing the contributions of African Americans throughout the years. Again, some of them you may recognize or may not. But this is a learning experience for each of us. We will begin with Vanessa Williams at this time, will be served. Muhammad Ali. Whitney Houston. Michael Jordan.